Children, our next topic is harmful effects of fossil fuel. Means how fossil fuel has disadvantages and they affect our environment. The first point is burning of coal and diesel. Coal and diesel both are fossil fuel. As a result of burning of coal and diesel, many products are released. Carbon monoxide, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxide, and with smoke. Means these gases and smoke, these are released by burning of coal and diesel. Now oxides of sulfur and nitrogen, so they dissolve in rainwater and they form acids. These oxides, they remain in the air and they react with the moisture and dissolve in the rainwater and form acid. Such rain is called acid rain, and the first rain, when the first rain take place, so that is acidic rain. The first rain is very harmful because it is acid rain. It causes, because the acids are corrosive in nature, so they cause damages to building, soils, harms crops, and causes severe breathing problem. So they are very harmful. Now come to the second point, global warming. Children, you are aware of this topic, global warming. Global warming means the temperature of the earth increases globally. The phenomena which causes heat to be trapped in the atmosphere because of excessive amount of greenhouse gases. Greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, methane, chlorofluorocarbon, nitrogen oxide mainly. And the slow increase in the atmospheric temperature is called global warming. Now understand these lines again. Global warming means this is the phenomena and which causes heat to be trapped. Because of this phenomena, heat is trapped in the atmosphere. Trapped means retained. Atmosphere mein hi retain ho gayi because of excessive amount of greenhouse gas. The main reason is the carbon dioxide, methane, chlorofluorocarbon, nitrogen oxide, these gases retain in the atmosphere. And the slow increase in the atmospheric temperature, slowly that atmospheric temperature is increased. Children, you have feel that the temperature of the earth is increasing day by day, and that is only due to global warming, because these gases act as a blanket and they prevent the backflow of the solar radiations, reflected solar radiation. When the solar radiation reaches the earth's surface, then they get reflected and go back into the space. But because of these gases, these radiation can't go back into the space and retained by the atmosphere. So the temperature of the atmosphere or the earth increases. So this is mainly due to the release of residue from the fossil fuel and other appliances. The fossil fuel and other appliances, they release residue on their burning. Global warming has adverse effect on climate. This affect our climate. The rise in the sea level due to melting of polar ice. When the heat increases, polar ice caps melt, and as a result the water in the sea level increases. And this is one of flooding is the one situation because of global warming, and flooding in the coastal region. So this is a common phenomena, common scene, okay, in the monsoon season. And nowadays you have heard about the floods in the different places also. Now come to the next topic, conservation of fossil fuel. Conservation of fossil fuel means how can we conserve, how can we preserve fossil fuel. Children, about fossil fuel, we know that these are non-renewable resources. Non-renewable resources means that once they used up or finished, they cannot be produced again. So we have to conserve them. Energy saved is energy produced. Okay, the first point is energy saved is energy produced. Now second is, to conserve fuel, we must reduce the wastage of energy in any form. We must be conserve in energy use. We must reduce the wastage of energy in any form. Use of fossil fuel should be minimized as these fuel produce harmful gases and smoke, and that causes air pollution and damage the environment. The on burning these produce harmful gases which causes acidic rain, global warming. So we have to minimize their use. To protect the environment, we have to minimize their use. Now come to next point. We should use alternative sources of energy like hydro energy, solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy, nuclear energy. These energy sources don't cause any type of pollution. So we have to shift to alternate source of energy like hydro energy. Hydro energy means the energy which we get from water. Solar energy, the energy we get from sun. Wind energy, by the use of the moving winds we are getting energy. Tidal energy, by the energy we get from tides. And nuclear energy, the energy which we get from the nucleus, heavy atom like uranium, thorium, etc. Now in villages and small town, cow dung and agricultural waste are easily available. These are used to produce biogas. Biogas, this has proved to be cheap, efficient fuel and also a good alternative source of energy. Biogas. In villages, biogas plant can be set up, and in the biogas plant, the agricultural waste, cow dung and different waste, domestic waste, so these can be dumped very easily, and by the decomposition process biogas is produced, and the biogas can be used in the cooking and lighting. Biogas has proved to be very cheap, efficient fuel and also a good alternative source of energy. In India, the Petroleum Conservation Research Association PCRA, this has advised people to follow few rules to save petrol and diesels. So what are these rules? So these rules are to drive at constant and moderate speed. We should not increase our vehicle speed very fast. So we have to drive at constant and moderate speed. Second point is to switch off the engine at traffic light. When you are at the traffic light and traffic is not clear to you, so switch off the engine. Third point is to ensure correct tire pressure. In your vehicle, the tire pressure must be correct. And last point is to ensure regular maintenance of vehicle. If you are having vehicle, using vehicle, then you have to maintain that also regularly. Okay, beta. Now by this, the chapter is completed.